Hello everybody and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today on Dark Tries, we're going to be having a look at this. This is the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway Stroudley D1 Class 042 tank, brought to Train Simulator by Caledonia Works. So, what is the D1? The D1s were a class of 042 tank locomotive designed by William Stroudley for the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway. 125 members of the class were built at Brighton Works between 1873 and 1887. The locomotives acquired the nickname Bulldogs by locomotive crews due to the fact that they were enlarged terriers, also a design by William Stroudley. All 125 members of the class were originally named, but in later life with the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway, they all lost their names when being repainted into Marsh Umber. The locomotives were later modified by Douglas Earl Marsh of the London, Brighton and South Coast, and this included the changing of the chimneys and the smoke box doors, among other things. The class entered Southern Railway ownership in 1923, having served throughout the First World War, and they put in sterling work for the Southern Railway, mainly on passenger trains, but they were also very good on freight trains as well, being a pretty decent mixed traffic locomotive. The class also had push-pull gear, so they could operate push-pull trains as well, on branch lines. The locomotive served with World War II, and unfortunately, not many survived into nationalisation, and the class were all gone by the early 1950s, with none being preserved. Now that we've had a brief history of the class, we shall now have a look at the liveries included with the pack, and we shall have a look at the cab and the sounds, and we will go for a short drive with the D1 tank. So, without further ado, let's have a look at the liveries included with the pack. So, the first livery that we're going to have a look at is this one. This is London, Brighton and South Coast Railway Stroudley Improved Engine Green. And the version of the model that I've put down here is in original Stroudley condition, as can be seen by the dome type and the chimney type. Though there are other things that can be customised on the locomotives, such as clack valves, condensing gear, smoke boxes, and coal rails on the bunkers. As you can see from this one, the locomotive is named Bramber. Now that's because most of the class, I think maybe all of the class actually, were named after places served by the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway. And as you can have a look at, it's very well lined out. We're just going to have a little orbit around the locomotive here and have a look in. So here you can see the builder's plate on the side there, Brighton Works 1873. We can also have a look at the name here. In the pack, there is actually name paints for every member of the class of the D1s. And they are only available really on the London, Brighton and South Coast Improved Engine Green livery, which is probably the most famous livery that these engines probably wore. Or at least it's the most recognisable to the general public. And as you can see here, you've got the nice 3D number plate at the back here, number 246, London, Brighton and South Coast Railway. It's a bit of an unusual wheel arrangement, isn't it, when you look at it? It's a 042 tank, but that large rear wheel looks like it should really be connected to the rest of them, making it look more like an E1 tank, I suppose. So, as we have a further look around the locomotive, you can have a look for yourself at the detail on the lining and paint, and you can probably see just off to the left there, we've got the other locomotives that we're going to be looking at. As you can see there as well, you've got the Westinghouse pump on this side. And if we look on this side, you can also see a bit more of that dome I spoke about earlier on. In later times, they were modified by Marsh to have different domes and different chimneys. But they did have several types of smoke boxes as well. So, as you can see on this one, it's got the short straps on the side there on the right-hand side. And, yeah, I must admit, it's quite a handsome little livery. And it's very well put together. Very good indeed. So, that was the first one. Now let's move across to the next livery. Now I have kind of cheated a little bit there's actually two different versions of this London, Brighton and South Coast Railway livery. And there's also several different types of locomotive you can put down, whether being in Stroudley condition or Marsh condition. This one, as you can see, is still in Stroudley condition because the dome is the same. And you can also see that this one has the Marsh Umber, and it also says here LB&SCR. Now, there is another version of this which has just LBSCR, but I put this one down because I quite like that ampersand. It looks a little bit like an 8 that's been squashed with a C. It's very nice. Actually, I didn't know whether I would quite like this livery. I've never really been a fan of Marsh Umber, but the more I've looked at it, the more I've kind of liked it. If I bring this camera around this way, you can also see that sometimes when I look at Marsh Umber, I think, oh, you know, it's just brown with a bit of black. But actually, if you look very carefully at the sides of the tanks, it's actually more like a dark purple around the sides of the tanks. That's quite nice to see. So if I continue orbiting the camera around here, you can see that the number there is still 3D, number 239. And if you just look to your sort of left-hand side there, you can also see the different types of bunkers that the class would have had. So you can see this one has the no coal rail. The one next to us has sort of a more open coal rail. And the one slightly further on has a closed up coal rail. The other thing you might also notice is the air tanks underneath the bunkers here. I don't think they're actually air tanks. I think they were more for the push-pull operations that the class would have done. So they're for the push-pull gear. I think they were air operated. Somebody will probably correct me in the comments anyway. But yeah, if we continue around, just look at the detail we've got on this livery. It's really nice. It's actually probably one of my favourites in the pack. My favourite in the pack is a lot later on, but we'll have a look at that one a little bit later on, won't we? So, yeah, that is the Marsh Umber livery. Next up is Yuri Green, which to me is sort of more of a pea green, I guess. I think it's also been called pea green by other people before. But this is probably one of the liveries they would have worn when just going into the Southern Railway. And as you can see again, you've got the build plate there. This one's also still in Stroudley condition. But if I move the camera up so we can just see the next one along, you can see that the dome is slightly different there, and the chimney's also ever so slightly different, and that dictates that this is one of the Marsh rebuilds that we're going to be looking at next. But, yeah, you can also see on the southern one that the black is sort of also slightly purpley. I don't know whether that's just me, but that looks kind of smart anyway. And as you can see here, you've got the customizable bunker there, and you can also see on this particular one, there are no condensing pipes and no clack valves here at the front. And I think it's also, yet again, got a different... Yeah, here you go. You can see that it's got longer straps on the smoke box door. And you can see the comparison there between the last one and this one. So that's where they would have been modified slightly in later times. So now we move on to this, which is the early Maunsell Green. And this is in Southern livery with the B dictating it was a Brighton locomotive due to the numbering sequences needing to be worked out. Don't know why I said needing, I meant needing. And this one again has the condensers and the clack valves, as you can see there. And I don't know, I mean, this livery is okay. It's probably one of the most common they would have been seen in, along with the number next to them. Number next to them? Member next to them. I think the main difference between them, I'm not actually sure what the main difference is between the two here, but if you move the camera this way, you can sort of see that there is a slight difference, I think, in the colour between these two particular types. Yeah, one is slightly lighter and the other one is quite a bit darker. So, yeah, on the left-hand side there, you've got the early version and you've got the slightly later version there. And as you can see here, this is where they had their original sort of numbers. So you've got 617 and 633. That's when they were first renumbered, I believe. And if we move on to the next one, which is the slightly later Southern Railway Green, you can see that the class were now given an extra digit to their numbers. So, yeah, very good indeed, very nice. And especially for me, because, you know, having more Southern Railway tank engines is always a bonus. They would pop up quite well on certain routes and certain things, so we'll have to see where that goes. So, yeah, we'll just have a proper look around at this one. So you've got Southern, 2229 there. In fact, I think there is a difference. There is a slight colour difference as well, I think, between them. But you can also see that there is another difference on the back of the bunkers. You can see that now that cast plate at the back there that says Southern Railway with their number has been replaced with just their number painted on the back there. So those are the sort of Maunsell liveries for the class. Next up, we've got the last of the Maunsell liveries, kind of. This is Southern Railway unlined green, and this would have been when they were put into use during the Bullied Zero, because it is Bullied Zero of Southern written on the side of the tank here in his famous little font. And as you can see here, you've got number 2226 at the back on the bunker side, and this time no number painted on the back of the engine. So yeah, you get quite a bit bang for your buck actually for this pack. There's quite a lot of liveries included, especially as we shall see, even though they didn't last into British Railways days, they still had quite a variety of liveries. And, you know, they look pretty good, actually. Now, we're on to my favourite livery in the entire pack, which is this. This is Bullied Malachite Lined Green. And doesn't that look so splendid? You can see, you know, the intricacies of the lining. Just a very bright colour as well. It's really nice to see a brightly coloured tank engine. And as you can see here, it's got Bullied's lettering there. Southern written there. And then lettering on the sides of the bunkers, but not at the back. So you can also see the different types of coal rail again there. You've got the open one on the left and the closed type on the right. You've also noticed probably that they've got this little toolbox on the back. I don't think they were ever rebuilt with larger bunkers or anything, so I'm not sure whether that's something that happened to them. But yeah, this is, I think, is probably my favourite livery in the pack. And as you can see, they were, you know, they did have condensing gear and clack valves later on in life. I'm not sure how prototypical all of them would have been, but I'm presuming at least some would have kept the condensing gear in later life. So that's the livery they probably would have been wearing at the beginning of the war. And after the war, after getting very dirty, they would have worn this. This is the unlined Southern Malachite. And it's almost as good as the lined, but in my opinion, I do like some lining. But, you know, it looks very smart anyway, and that shade of green is just, I don't know how people don't like Malachite Green. It looks very nice. Let me know in the comments whether you like the Malachite Green or not, actually, if you've gotten this far into the video without switching off. But, yeah, that's what they would have worn, probably after the war. Now, during the war, they would have been painted into this, which is basically a very plain black livery with just Southern and then their numbers written on the sides there. I'll give you a little orbit anyway. But there's not really much else I can say about this particular livery. Just that it's the same as that Malachite one there, but black. You can also see, actually, there is a bit of a difference, actually, in the way the lining's done. So you can see this one has on the 2299 yellow, sunshine yellow with the green backing. But on the Malachite, this one, you can see that it's actually sort of got more of a black backing. So there is actually a bit of a difference between the different types. But, yeah, I'm not sure whether I 100% like the sort of black. I think it sort of dictates. I think these things look better lined out, or at least with some colour. But, you know, during the war they had to wear the black. So towards the very end of the war they would look like this probably. So this is Southern Railway black, but this is all grubby and greasy and everything, and you can see the little bit of some water that's probably leaked out of the filler caps coming down the side there. Maybe a little bit too shiny. It'd be good to actually just take this model actually and take off the bump mat, the alpha layer, and just make it actually look properly grimy. But, you know, fairness, where it's due. It doesn't really affect anything else on the model. I think it's just a personal preference. If you've got a weathered loco, you don't want to see that sort of shine. The only shine I'd really like to see is sort of where the water is on the tanks. I've seen this done on Chris's previous locomotives. I think the Beetle Crusher, the 060 dock tank, that had a very similar effect where the water sort of shines a bit more. Might just be me, but I can see it shining a little bit more than the rest, but I think it's more dramatic, I guess, on the 060 Caledonian tank. So that's basically almost all the liveries done, because we're not going to see any other colours, but here we have the Southern Railway black, but as after the war, not many of these survived into British Railways days, they didn't really get painted into BR black, but they did receive BR numbers, so they would have been renumbered here like this. A 3 would have been added to the front of their number, so 3,000 added. So this one would have ended up being originally probably started out as 359, then it would have been renumbered 2359, and then in British Railway days this one would have been 32359. In fact, it could actually be only 32359 that actually received this. If I just scooch back over here to the weathered one, because we'll look at that as well in a minute. Yeah, it looks like it. So the only survivor into British Railways days was 32359. Now, I also know that there was one member of the class that was used for an asylum railway, which is basically like a railway for a, you know, the what you would call the, without sounding horrible, the lunatic asylums. One of these locomotives was used sort of in the industry, I suppose you'd say, but I don't think there's much on the livery at war, and I don't think it's really so important because that railway was very obscure and we wouldn't have seen it anyway, so not really worth including it in the pack. And plus, there are reskinners out there, so if anybody does want to reskin it, go for it. Not really much else to say about this final livery. It's the Southern unlined black again, but with the BR number and weathered again. So, yeah, overall then, what do I think of the amount of liveries you get? Well, for the price that you pay for the pack, it's not that bad. I know there have been other packs with lots more liveries, but there's also quite a bit of customization with these. So, overall, I think it's pretty good, especially if you are a Southern lover like me. So, yeah, there you go. Let's have a nice zoom out of all the liveries that are in the pack, minus, like, one, which is the Marsh Umber, as I said previously. So, that's us having a look at the liveries. So now, I think I should go and get into one of these things, and we should have a look at the cab and the sounds and go for a little drive. So, let's go and do that. So then, here we are at Exeter Central with one of the D1 tanks in Malachite Green. We're going to be taking a little train up the line along the West of England main line. But before we leave, let's have a look at the cab, and then we will think about me shutting up and putting the sound up so you can listen to the locomotive as it goes along the line. So here we are inside the cab of the locomotive. As you can see, well detailed in here. If you want to switch the light off, it's there, the lamp there. But for the purpose of this bit, I'll leave it on. If you want to use performance mode, it's Shift P to turn performance mode onto low, which turns off shadows, and Ultra Max, which turns it all off altogether. You've also got the reverser here, which this time hasn't got a reverser lock because the real locomotive didn't have a reverser lock. You've got your firebox down there. You've got your Bible there and also a pipe. Oh, that's nice. You get a little pipe as well. Regulator there in the middle. Water there. And I think this also has an interesting speedometer, which is there. And I think it's something like the ball moves up and speed goes along. We'll have to have a look at that maybe as I'm rolling around in the cab. But we'll have a look at the little camera views from the station. So obviously you've got your driver's side here, back of the cab here, the fireman side of the cab here, just out here, down by the wheels, which obviously are blocked by the platform, up here at the front, along here at the front, obviously blocked by platform, but you've also got in front of the locomotive there, down there, in front, by the side there, in there, at the front on this side, along this side, along this side, and then back up and outside of there. So I think, yep, if we just move over, I did put some AI traffic in this, so what we've just seen there is a beautiful H2 Atlantic coming into Exeter with a passenger train. You can also hear, even though I've got the volume very low, the air pump at the moment going. So when the sound goes up, we'll probably hear that a little bit more. But yeah, we are in the Malachite Green livery. That's pretty much everything for in the cab. You can see there you've also got some wrenches. The other thing is this locomotive has the new Locomotion 1.5 script. So that means that it's also got the new Caledonia Works Auto Fireman, which I will be putting on in a moment before we start our run. But first, let's just come back to the front a moment because I didn't show properly, or at all, the customization of the head code. So as usual, you can pick a head code like that from 1 to 6 on the lamp irons. You can also change what they are. So if we just go along, you can see there's multiple different types there. So different coloured lamps for different coloured things. You've also got the discs as shown there. And I think on the earlier versions, you've also got some different types of indicator discs, such as one with a black circle in the middle. And you've got another one with, it's a square. And there's a few other ones that are in there as well. So with that bit out of the way, let's move back into the cab so that I can switch the auto fireman on. So you do that with Control R. And that takes over the firing and takes over the injectors for you. So that's all that sorted out. I think now we should go for a little run. So without further ado, let's take the Caledonia Works, London, Brighton and South Coast Railway Stroudley D1 class out for a little run. Thank you. So, that was the London, Brighton and South Coast Railway Stroudley D1 class tank engine from Caledonia Works. I hope you all enjoyed the video, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye!